Hello, welcome to another video from Far North Bushcraft and Survival. My name is Lonnie, and thanks for joining me. A while back I did a video and where I mentioned birch twig tea, and I was asked, well, how do you make birch twig tea? So that's what this video is going to be about. And first of all, we're going to need to get some birch twigs. Okay, so the problem is that the birch twigs are all up real high, and it's hard to find any that are down low and accessible. But here we've got an obliging tree. So stay with me while I go get some birch twigs. Okay, this could be one of those videos where the disclaimer is, don't do this at home. If you're going to do something like this, do it on your own, of course. I'm not recommending you climb up a tree. And the way things are all screwed up nowadays politically, you got to be careful what you say. Okay, so, birch twigs. You want twigs that have buds on the end. I'll show you. Okay, some of these are dead here. Here's a live one. Okay, you can tell when you try to bend it. Also, you can tell by when you pop off a little twig and you chew on it. Is it soft? Is it flavorful? That's what you want to look for. Now, if it's dead, it's going to snap off. As you can see, these are not snapping off. Instead, they're flexing quite a bit, and that's what you want. But taste it and see if it's flexible and tasty. If it's dead, it'll be just a dry woody taste. Okay, I'm gonna continue gathering, and then I'll be right back. Quite a few good twigs here. Now let's take them back to the camp and I'll show you what to do next. Alright, now what we do is we want just the twig tips. Something like this is fine. Take the whole twig. Once the twig gets okay, you can see that the buds grow on a little stem. And once the twig gets bigger than those stems, then don't bother. Just pull the bud off itself. Just like that. And once you get a nice handful in there, then you can go ahead and add your water and fix it up. Okay, that's how you do it. Alright, we've got us a little bunch in here. Now we'll go ahead and add water to it and put it on the fire. Okay, I'll get back to you when this is done. Okay, you let the water reach a boil, and it's just about to a boil here. In fact, I think we got a boil now. So once it reaches a boil, you can see the steam coming out of the spout. Go ahead, take it off, and let it steep for 5-10 minutes. Okay, this has sat for a while and cooled down, steeped long enough. I'll show you how much water I had in there. Poured enough to just basically cover the twigs. All right. Now you, of course, will want to adjust the twig amount of twigs or the amount of water, you know, to suit your taste. Now, how this request came about was I was telling about a snowshoe hike that I went on into a lake near our cabin, and coming back I was just wore out. I was exhausted. So I stopped and I got out my little wood stove, my Bushbox XL that I've got, made a little fire in it and cooked me some of this birch twig tea. And I felt quite refreshed afterwards. And I don't know if it was the tea that helped or if it was the break that helped or both, but I was quite refreshed and able to continue the journey on the way back out. Now, it's a little hot. Let's go cool it off. Get some snow here and cool it off a little bit. Pretty tasty. And I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and we'll see you on the next video. You guys take care.